Namaste. Welcome to the next video of Machine Learning Techniques course. In this video, we'll visualize ridge and lasso solutions as function of regularization rate lambda. The ridge regression model adds a ridge penalty to the linear regression loss function. The penalty is of the form of the square of the weight vector, and it is weighted by the value of lambda, or the regularization rate. Whenever we use value of lambda equal to 0, we have a linear regression loss function without regularization, and that is likely to overfit if we use a very aggressive polynomial regression with high degrees. On the other hand, if we use a very high value of lambda, what would happen is this particular constraint term or the penalty term has a very high value which overshadows the first part of the equation, thereby getting a solution which has the weight vector of 0. And this particular solution represents an underfitting situation where the model is not able to learn the mapping between input and output. And if we use a very small value of lambda, on the other hand, we are likely to get overfitted solution. So we need to select the value of lambda between these two extremes of underfitting and overfitting. And here, what we'll try to do is we'll try to visualize the solution path between these two solutions, one which underfits, and on the other side we have a solution that overfits. So we are trying to see the solution path between these two extremes in case of ridge as well as in case of lasso regression models. The first part of the equation, which is the linear regression loss function, represents elliptical contours, whereas the penalty term in case of ridge regression has circular contours. In order to visualize the solution path, we follow a procedure where we first generate a synthetic data. And here in this case, we have generated synthetic data with 40 examples. We obtain the weight vector for a ridge regression model with 100 different values of lambda. So now we have weight vectors for different values of lambda. We set up a mesh grid of weight values. And for each value in this particular mesh, we compute the mean squared error using a pure linear regression formulation, and also compute the ridge regularization, or the constraint term for those values of W. We draw contours for the mean squared error and ridge regression constraints. And on top of that, we draw path of weight vector from the least mean squared error value to the least value of ridge constraints, which appears at 0, 0. So let's look at the solution path. So you can see that the ridge constraints are marked by the circular contours, and the blue point is the value of the least constraints which is situated at 0, 0. So when we have zero values for both weights W0 and W1, naturally the penalty value would be 0. On the other hand, the linear regression loss has elliptical contours, and the point over here which is marked by a red cross is the solution of the linear regression equation or linear regression model, and that point has got the least value of the loss. So we have now two points: a point where we have the least value of the linear regression loss function, and this is the point where we have the least value of the constraint term. And remember, whenever we get solution over here, this is highly underfitting solution. And if we get a solution over here, this is likely to overfit. It may not overfit in all the situation, but it is likely to overfit. And then for different values of lambda in between, we have different values of weight vectors, which are denoted by these circles. And you can see that for different values of lambda, we get a value of weight vector which is somewhere in between these two extremes. So if you use smaller values of lambdas, we will get the value of weight vector which is closer to the solution of the linear regression model. And if we use higher values of lambda, we will get solution which is closer to the optimal solution of the constraint. So these are different points, and we need to select lambda such that our model is neither underfitting nor overfitting. And the solution lies at the intersection of these two contours, the elliptical contours and the circular contours. And we have shown these contours only at certain levels, but we can draw these contours continuously. So, you know, each value or each dot over here represent a potential solution for the corresponding value of lambda. And now you can see that why a ridge regression model gets us a solution which is non-sparse. So we have seen earlier that ridge regression model results in a solution where it assigns smaller values to the weights rather than assigning zero values to the weights. And this is because we have a constraint which is circular, which is the equation of the circle in this particular case. And when these elliptical contours meet this circle, they meet at a point where both the weight vectors are likely to have non-zero values, and that's why we get weight vectors that are non-zero in case of ridge regression model. Now let's repeat the same process with Lasso, but in this case we'll use Lasso constraints instead of the ridge constraints. The first part of the equation remains the same. This is the equation of this is the loss of the linear regression model. We add the L1 constraint to it, or so this the resulting loss is called a loss for Lasso regression model. We follow the same process. We generate synthetic data. We obtain weight vector for Lasso regression model with 100 different values. We set up the mesh grid of weight values, and for each weight value we compute the mean square error and compute the Lasso regularization term. We draw contours for mean square error and Lasso regression constraint, and we draw the path of weight vector from the least mean square error value to the least value of Lasso constraint, which again appears at 0, 0 just like ridge constraints. Now the Lasso constraint represent another geometrical figure which is polytope, and we have contours which are the polytope contours. And again we have the linear regression loss function is represented by elliptical contours, and the point over here is the point of least constraint of Lasso regularization. So for this particular point, both the values of weight vectors are zero, so the value of the constraint is also zero, and this is the point of least loss or error value, and this is the solution of the linear regression equation. So when we have a small value of lambda, we will get solution which is closer to the linear regression solution, whereas if we use very high value of lambda, we will get solution which is closer to the solution of the constraint. And here, as you can see, if we use the value of lambda closer to the value of the solution, you can see that this particular elliptical contours will meet the polytope at the corner, and at that corner value of, let's say here, the value of W0 is 0 and value of W1 is some kind of a non-zero value. That's why we get a sparse solution in case of Lasso regularization. The elliptical contours are more likely to meet at the corner of the polytope, and at the corner of the polytope, one of the in this case, one of the weight vector, one of the weight values will be 0 and other will be a non-zero. And you can generalize this whenever you have more than let's say two features, more than two weights. Okay, so in that case also, the elliptical contours are likely to meet the polytope contours at corners, and at corners we have a sparse solution. And whenever this polytope contour meets, whenever the elliptical contours meet the polytope contour at the sides, we get a non-sparse solution. So hope these two visualizations would have helped you to understand intuition between ridge and lasso regression. And now this visualization also gives a good idea why lasso gives a sparse solution, whereas ridge regression solutions are not that sparse. This brings us to an end of linear regression topic. And in this particular module, we looked at linear regression model of a single variable. We started with linear regression, went on to learn polynomial regression, and in order to control the problem of overfitting in higher order polynomial models, we learned regularization, two types of regularization in particular, ridge and lasso. Now we will, in the next video, we will extend these ideas to multi-output regression model.